My name is Yasuko Takezawa. I'm based at the Institute for Research in the Humanities of Kyoto University. I was trained in cultural anthropology, but because of the job here, which is to run a collaborative research project and edit anthologies, my fields of interest has expanded to include not only history and sociology, but also genetics to physical anthropology to art. My fundamental question is why and how the human categorizes others, what they label others, and what meanings they attach to each category, which in turn explains how socioeconomic inequality and discrimination can arise. This book, Fudo, the English title is Climate and Culture, written by Tetsuro Watsuji, who is a philosopher and was considered to be part of a Kyoto school, is important to me because it completely changed my mind about what I would want to study at the university. Before then, I loved math and language grammar, but I was so excited when I read it. And then I went to a library and checked out the book. And when I read it thoroughly, it was like a revelation to me. And it was particularly interesting that he argues that it is in-betweenness of nature and human that shape culture and human mind, not like a dichotomy of human versus nature. These are the transcripts of my interviews with the second and third generation Japanese Americans. The Nisei were on average only 19 years old when they were put into incarceration camps during World War II. Their stories are hard even to listen to. And that was why it was very moving when they started talking about their experiences, which they had suppressed for decades after the war. After the Widows' Movement started. When I later returned to Japan after I finished my dissertation, I had to consider my positionality. Someone trained in the US and raised and now based in Japan, how could I contribute to the field? And then my childhood memories started to pop up. I grew up in a neighborhood, kind of a multi-ethnic neighborhood. Some of them are close friends of mine, and I didn't think about it for a long time, but after I returned from Japan, I started to build my own original theory, and then juxtaposing what I learned in the States. And the story of Japanese Americans is, I think, it's a good lesson of what it's like when the dominant Japanese becomes a minority, and it tells us how we should live along with different ethnic groups in Japan.